Hey, welcome to Wiha Wednesday. My name is Dan.
I'm Andrew.
We're going to talk about torque control today.
So we got low torque, we got mid-range torque, and we got high torque, and we got it for multiple applications. Let's start out with the low torque. So we got a TorqueFix.
This is a TorqueFix wing. This is an excellent tool for the machine tool world where you're changing out cutter heads and you don't want to take the tool off the machine.
And then what about maybe you want a little lower priced option with maybe, you know, it's a fixed torque.
So this is our EasyTorque. We have various different amounts of torque settings, but they are all in different separate handles.
And then here's another smaller TorqueFix, but showing the blades that are available. There's also extensions.
And these ones are actually certified, but they're also got the same type of deal as EasyTorque. They come in different fixed settings, but this one is a certified tool.
And now what about maybe an intermediate variable torque?
This is our variable torque. These ones are plus or minus 6%. These ones are just good all around drivers. If you have many different torque value needs, these ones are adjustable.
Maybe for like gunsmiths, mechanics.
Yep.
Anytime you really want to make sure you're torquing at the right range. And what about for electricians?
Electricians, we have you covered. We have our insulated version of the torque control, and these ones have lockable blades that they have in them. So once you choose your selection of blades that Wiha has, you put it in, they lock in, they're not gonna fall out in the box on you, set your torque and go.
And you'll also be able to use those slimline blades with other slimline handles, like the stubby and then the standard handle. So you don't have to torque with those. And then what about if you're working on electronics, like this, or cell phones, and you make sure you're torquing those properly.
We have ESD. These handles are typically come in inch ounce instead of inch pounds, just because the torque values on most electronics is super low.
And what if you want to get really precise and dial it into a specific newton meter, or even convert maybe the iTorque? Can you talk about that?
Yep, so the iTorque, this is something that we primarily see in lab use when people need to go in between newton meters and inch pounds. This tool does both. It also has a cycle counter in it so that you can keep track of how many cycles you did if you're working on a specific job.
And now what if you want to go really high torque?
So once you get out of the kind of range where you can't really use a screwdriver handle, we have a T-handle option that will go up to 14 newton meters. And this one should have you covered as far as the stuff you'd be doing by hand, you know, without going too high.
And then what if you want to extend that with like sockets or
other options? We have options of different holders that go in this tool that offer a 3A socket, a quarter inch socket option, or your standard type of insert bit.
And that's the same for most of the torque.
Most of the torque range has all that.
You have different adapters options to connect with different options.
Yep.
Awesome. Thanks for watching, guys.
I'm Dan.
I'm Andrew.
See you next time.